Hey, Tony here. Today I'm going to show you my 10 saddest films that I have in my collection. So stick around. So with having such a large collection, you know that there's got to be some sad movies in the collection. You know, I do like action movies, I like horror movies, but also I do like a good drama that has some really good sad storytelling in it. So today I wanted to take time to tell you about 10 films that I've got in my collection that I find to be sad. Now, with talking about some of these films, there may be some spoilers, so just be aware that there may be spoilers ahead. So first up, I'm going to talk about this movie called Terms of Endearment. Now, this is a movie I've seen many times and just recently rewatched it, and it still holds up. It's a really good story. It's got some comedic elements to it, but mostly it's a drama, and a family drama at that, regarding this mother and daughter's relationship. I find this movie to be pretty entertaining, but it does end up being a pretty sad movie toward the end with this relationship and what happens. So if you've never seen Terms of Endearment, definitely check this one out. Okay, next up, a sad movie I want to talk about is Manchester by the Sea, starring Casey Affleck, Michelle Williams, and Lucas Hedges. Now, I have not seen this movie since I saw it in the theater. And as many of you know, when I do go see a movie, I go in blindly. I don't like watching trailers. I like to be surprised. And so I was very surprised when I watched this one about how sad it really is. So this is a story about a brother who has to care for his nephew. I think he was 16-year-old nephew after his brother dies. And the town that they live in, it's a small town. Everybody pretty much knows everybody. And then the relationship between Casey Affleck and Michelle Williams' character and some things that happened during the movie that are really sad. So this movie is just sad all together. If you want to see a sad movie, every bit of this movie is pretty sad. I highly recommend you check it out. Okay, next up, I'm going to talk about Beaches. Now, this is a movie I haven't seen since I saw this one in the theater, but I do remember this being a very sad movie toward the end. But a really great story. I really enjoyed the music. It's got a lot of good music, of course, because Bette Midler's in it. But just the whole storytelling aspect of it, of how these two ladies grew up together and their relationship throughout their lives. Just a really good, heartwarming story. Very fun to watch, so definitely check that one out. Okay, next up, I'm going to talk about this movie called Lion. I have not seen this movie since I saw it in the theater. It was another big surprise for me. I really enjoyed it. Great performances by everyone that was involved. It's a very sad story about adoption, about a little boy growing up in a family that is not his own, and just with memories that of things that happened throughout his childhood. Just a really good heartwarming story. It's sad, and definitely check it out if you want to be sad. Okay, next up is a movie called Marley and Me. If you're an animal lover, this is a great movie to watch. It is a very, it's an entertaining movie as far as kind of like a romantic comedy, but it does have some sad points to it, of course, involving this little dog as it grows up. But just another sad film that I think you would enjoy checking out. I think a lot of people have probably already seen this movie. Next up is a movie called Steel Magnolias. I've seen this one many times. It's one of my wife's favorites. I saw this one in the theater for the first time. It's got a really great all-star cast in it, great storytelling, and some very sad moments throughout the movie about this group of women who live in the same town and how their relationships interact with each other. And some sad moments toward the end of the movie toward the middle of the movie and how that progresses. So really good story, Steel Magnolias. Okay, next up is another film that I saw back in the theater when it was released in 87, I believe. I've seen this movie many times. The first time I watched this one was in the theater, of course. I watched it and I remember enjoying it so much that I bought another ticket and invited my brother and a friend to go watch it with me just to see their reactions, and just overall great movie. I enjoyed this one. It is a very long movie. It's got such a great story about it, and it's got some really sad elements throughout the movie. And I probably one of my top 10 favorite movies of all time, The Color Purple. So check that out if you've never seen it. Okay, next up is another film that I saw in the theater without knowing what I was going to go see. And this is Beautiful Boy, starring Steve Carell and Timothy Chalamet. Really great film, discussing addiction and how it messes with the family, and how this father really wanted to help his son throughout his life with this struggle with addiction. And it's just a very sad story throughout the whole film. Just some really great acting and some great storytelling. If you've ever dealt with any kind of family member that has any kind of addiction issues, then this will definitely hit home. I highly recommend this one. Okay, next up is a Netflix movie that I enjoy, and it's called Marriage Story, starring Scarlett Johansson and Adam Driver. Very well acted and performed. A great story regarding marriage and then divorce, and how it affects this young family, and all the different things that happen throughout the story involving this divorce. Just a lot of sad storytelling, and some great performances. If you've never seen this one, definitely check it out. Okay, lastly is a movie called The Father. Man, I really enjoyed this film. It was so very well done. Just the whole aspect of the way that they told this story, how it was filmed, and definitely the performances in this particular movie were just outstanding. Anybody that has a family member that has struggled with dementia or Alzheimer's, I would highly suggest you watch this. I think the way that they did this film and the way that it was edited really gives you a great feel for what families go through and what an Alzheimer's patient might actually go through day by day, not really realizing what's going on with their mind and with the things that are changing around them. If you've never seen The Father, I highly recommend you check this one out. You will not be disappointed. So those are 10 films that I have in my collection that are very sad. Now leave me a comment below. Let me know if you have any recommendations of other sad films that you've seen that you would like me to check out. I really do enjoy reading your recommendations, and there's a lot of films that I've added to my collection because of your recommendations, so keep leaving them. If you like what you saw here today, please give it a thumbs up and share the video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I really appreciate it if you would subscribe. If you do subscribe, please remember to hit that notification bell so that you can be notified every time I upload a new video. If you haven't found me on my social media accounts, I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and on TikTok. And if you'd like to find out what I've been watching, you can find me over on Letterboxd. I do have links below. But thanks again for watching, and we will see you next time.